sounding points and contact points. And we're very specific about which lane that they are in. So Fritz Kreisler has developed a concept called, we call it these days, the Kreisler Highway. So this is lane 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, right over the fingerboard. So here's 1. Here's 2. Here's 3. Here's 4. And here's 5. Which sound sounds the most focused? Most of them will probably say 3 or 4.
Lane 3. Lane 1. Lane 2. Lane 4.
So we explain to students that when going from the high string to the low string, the hand leads, elbow follows. So that means there's a puppet master pulling the string going up. Now we're going from the low string to the high string, the elbow drops. So we pull the puppet master strings and elbow goes down. Good. Hands up to G. Elbow down to E. Hands up to D. Elbow down to E. Hands up to G. Elbow down to A. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ta, ti, ti, tiri, tiri, ta. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ti, ti, ta, ti, ti. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ta, 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 ti, ti. Once the students are more developed in their playing, they can play open strings and have some basic left hand foundation. Then we use this book, I Can Read Music. This is for violin, and this is one for cello. We also have ones for viola. Now note that the violin book starts on A, which starts over here. But since our essential elements are D-based, make sure that you start your students reading the pitch page on the D section, which starts at lesson 22. One page is pitch, the next page is rhythm. Now, the rhythm page for the D section of violin is really complicated. We would keep the lesson 22 for pitch, but we would turn back to lesson 1 for the rhythm page so that the rhythm and the pitches are learning in the same level. For the cello, it's more straightforward. You can see that here. This is D's. Violin lesson 22 is the same notes as the cello.